on the ABC. We'd all like to think that we got our jobs because of our skills and charming personalities, but what if the only thing that got you that interview was a common-sounding name?
Say g'day to James, Fatima, Emma and Ning. They're all recent graduates with a similar set of skills highly suited to the job they're competing for. But sadly, they don't share the same chance of landing that gig, and it's all to do with their names.
There are many studies that show that employers discriminate against people solely because of their name.
The sad reality is that Ning, with his Chinese name, will have to submit 68% more CVs than James and Emma just to get an interview. For Fatima, whose name is Middle Eastern, it will be 64%.
So how the hell did I get this job?
But what if we got rid of names on CVs altogether?
The name-blind resume seems to me to be an excellent way of countering unconscious bias. It has to be seen as a temporary measure to get the fairness that we claim to have in our society.
It may seem bizarre, but hiring from nameless CVs is already compulsory in the UK public service, and Canada is looking to follow suit. For 27-year-old Melbourne girl Aki Nathan, name discrimination is a familiar obstacle.
I sent out my CV using my full Sri Lankan name, Akshita Vithyanandan, for over a year, and I got no callbacks, no replies. So I shortened my name to Aki Nathan. I got 2 callbacks within an hour, and I landed my job, which I'm still working at the moment.
But not everyone believes that stripping names from CVs is the right way to go.
It's not up to a candidate to disguise their ethnicity, their age, their gender, or whatever other attribute that may be discriminated against. It's up to employers to adopt a fair and non-discriminatory approach to recruitment.
So in an effort to give everyone a fair shot at getting a job, should Australian employers embrace nameless resumes?
Economist Usman W. Chohan thinks there are a lot of benefits to ditching names from CVs, probably because he has such a weird name. And he joins us now. Usman, how did you get a job?
I try to hope that they don't judge me based on just the name and they want to look at the qualifications too.
But do you think there's some merit to this idea?
I do believe that there's merit to the idea that there are subconscious biases in employers when they hire. A lot of data, in fact, all of the data that research has been done on this shows that there are subconscious biases in the employers.
Do you think it could be of benefit to women as well, to women who feel that they may be discriminated against based on sex when they're going for jobs?
Absolutely. So there's been studies done on academia in the United States and law firms in Canada, which show that women get systematically discriminated against because they have female names.
Well, what about people who use Comic Sans as their font in their CV? They should be discriminated against, shouldn't they?
They should. Even I'm against that.
I totally get the idea behind this, but it strikes me, if you look at a CV, there are lots of other ways you can kind of discern whether or not these people are, you can racially profile them or whatever. Maybe they went to a Jewish school or something, or, you know, or just all sorts of markers of where they grew up and things like that. Is there any way really to get around this? Are we fighting a losing battle?
You're making an excellent point. So there are some hints, like a Jewish school, you said, or that they studied in Rwanda when they were younger, or they studied in the 1960s, then you have a bias of age. So there are always ways to infer somebody's age or gender or race, but at least if you have a blanket like that, it helps at least in getting the foot in the door.
Usman, I would like to know if you did have to change your name at all. I mean, can you give us a popular name that we could put down on our resume?
I have no idea. Personally, I've never had to change my name, but I've been lucky that I've worked for companies or organizations that promote diversity as the definition of who they are. So my previous work was with the World Bank, and that's probably the most diverse organization in the world after the United Nations. So, you know, that's a good place for people to work if they want to avoid gender or racial discrimination. But private sector, it's a bit different, right?
But surely the name, for example, off the top of my head, Lachlan Murdoch would get you a job.
Just off the top of your head, right?
Well, Usman, thank you very much for taking us through this today.
Thank you, my pleasure.
Kid eating chocolate really makes us smarter. Chocolate eating scientists say yes.